Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Plant Water Relation and Mineral Nutrition. In that, we are studying topic type of diffusion. We all know that diffusion is the movement of gaseous molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. Today, we'll be studying what is the types of diffusion present. Diffusion. Whenever we say or talk about diffusion, we come to a simple definition. It is the movement of gaseous molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration. Spraying a perfume is diffusion. But there are various types of diffusion available. Today, we'll be seeing what are those types. The two main types of diffusion that are available in nature are simple diffusion and facilitated diffusion. When I say simple diffusion, it can take place on its own. Whereas facilitated diffusion needs help from certain transport proteins as well as certain molecules. Simple diffusion is nothing but particles directly move across the semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane is nothing but the membrane after cell wall, or you can say plasma membrane. So particles movement directly across the plasma membrane is nothing but simple form of diffusion. Movement of ions, you can say, a form of simple diffusion. Whereas when I talk about facilitated diffusion, it takes place with the help of certain molecules. During facilitated diffusion, transport proteins basically help to transfer the particles across membrane. Facilitated diffusion is used to carry molecules or particles which are very heavy. Example, ATP or adenosine triphosphate. To carry it, facilitated diffusion would be required. Now, the three main important proteins that help in facilitated diffusion are unipod protein, synpod protein and antipod protein. When I say unipod protein, it means it carries particle in one direction. When I say synpod protein, they carry two particles in one direction. And when I say antipod proteins, they are nothing but they carry two different particles in two different directions. Apart from that, facilitated diffusion could be of active type or it could be of passive type, depending upon the amount of energy that is required. Types of diffusion. Now, diffusion is of basic two types, simple diffusion and facilitated diffusion. During simple diffusion, particles move across the semi-permeable membrane, the membrane which allow the movement of certain molecules and which disallow or never allow the movement of certain molecules across the membrane with the help of certain ions, which could be NaCl ions. They do not require any transport proteins for their movement, neither they require any amount of extra energy or ATP for the moment. accelerated diffusion, or you can say the diffusion that helps or that takes place with the help of certain protein molecules. In facilitated diffusion, transport proteins help to move the particles across membranes from a region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration. And these proteins that help in the movement of particles are unipod protein, simpod protein, and antipod protein. Unipod proteins basically help to move one particle in one direction, whereas your simpod proteins help to move two particles in one direction. When I say antipod, it means in opposite direction. Antipod proteins move two different particles in two different directions. Example, whenever you have to use microtubules, microfilaments to carry, antipod proteins would play a very important role. Or you can say the movement of glucose distribution after the process of photosynthesis has taken place inside cell. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about the types of diffusion. One was simple diffusion, which did not require any protein. And another was facilitated diffusion, which required the help of protein. I hope we all are clear with this concept of simple diffusion and facilitated diffusion. Thank you.